These absolutely stunning and gorgeous rocks are in fact fossils, representing the remains of more than 200 million-year-old fossilized trees. Located approximately 24 miles east-northeast of the town of Holbrook, Arizona, is a protected area where a forest of these fossilized remains can be found, ranging from branches to full tree trunks, some even with the bark on them still present. These colorful Triassic Age fossils, which are truly one of a kind, exist in the tens of thousands within Petrified Forest National Park. While today, the climate of this region at 5,800 feet above sea level could be best classified as a cold semi-arid climate, if you would have only been in this very spot a mere 225 million years ago, you would have seen a completely different landscape. There would be nothing that resembled a modern desert, as instead there would have been a lush tropical rainforest teeming with life, albeit with plants and animals that looked highly foreign to us. In this hot and humid rainforest, which likely had a yearly average temperature 1 degree Celsius hotter than that of modern Phoenix, roamed small dinosaurs such as Coelophysis and Chindosaurus, alongside armadillo-like armored reptiles such as Desmatosuchus, which chewed away at low-lying vegetation. Meanwhile, in the air, flying reptiles such as pterosaurs roamed the skies. But, most importantly, the trees which were present were all conifers, with occasional small conifers such as Scalderia adamantica and Woodworthia arizonica, but primarily with 150 to 200 foot tall conifers known as Orcalioxycon arizonicum. These trees had typical trunk widths of 2 to 9 feet and existed in close proximity to a vast river system. This river system formed after the creation of highlands belonging to a volcanic arc in what is today southwest Arizona, causing rainwater which precipitated down them to flow to the northeast. In this late Triassic environment, trees would succumb to old age, decay, disease, alongside damage from storms and being eaten by other animals. As a result, sections of or the entirety of these ancient conifers occasionally fell into riverbeds, temporarily floating for a time downstream, until many of these collected in log jams. These trees eventually sunk to the bottom of the river in clusters where these log jams happened to be and were buried by mud and ash-rich clay known as bentonite. As layer after layer of these piled up over the buried trees, the silica within these sediments dissolved in the water. The silica-rich water then seeped down over time into the fossils, filling the pore spaces with silica where water and organic material once was in the tree. When the water evaporated, the silica would remain. This process, known as permineralization, repeated for millions of years until finally what remained was a three-dimensional internal mold of the tree fragment's original shape, being composed primarily of a type of cryptocrystalline silica known as chalcedony. Depending on the specific trace elements within the chalcedony, it could turn a spectacular array of colors. Red was typically caused by inclusions of the mineral hematite, orange by elevated iron and manganese, yellow by limonite inclusions, green due to very high levels of the element chromium and sometimes titanium, blue due to a combination of elevated copper, cobalt, and chromium, purple by elevated iron and titanium with very small spherules of hematite, brown via minor amounts of iron oxide inclusions, white via a lack of any notable elemental inclusions, and finally black via elemental carbon inclusions. However, these fossilized wood fragments, largely in the Chinle Formation, which were laid between 225 and 211 million years ago, were subsequently buried by numerous other layers. It was not until the uplift of the Colorado Plateau began 70 million years ago that increased erosion affected overlying layers. This increased rate of erosion eventually removed these overlying layers, revealing an ancient fossilized forest of Triassic-era trees for all to see. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Shane Arnondale, for supporting this channel.